card is on and it looks pretty awesome. The kick plate, oh, I'm knocking stuff over. I actually had to trim this up, so the one that, I mean, right out of the box, it was actually too wide and too tall, so I had to shave off like a, I don't know, a 16th of an inch on each side, on each, yeah, each side of the side art. But it looks pretty decent. I mean, you can't tell that I kind of cut it a little bit crooked. So yeah, let's get a step back and see what this thing looks like. It's one step closer. This is the fun stuff when you actually get to see that it's starting to come together. Even though the game's not in there yet, you can see like the light at the end of the tunnel, so to speak, with the when it's starting to look more and more like a completed machine. So we gotta do the marquee and the T-molding next. Alright, let's put the T-molding on first. And I got the purple T-molding. Purple T-molding off eBay. That seems to be the only place I can find purple T-molding. And I think it's 20 feet. So what you want to do, match your end pieces up, and then find the middle point, which is right here. And cut it. Now we got equal lengths for each side. So, and get my handy dandy rubber mallet. Ha! You just want to use a rubber mallet just so you don't scratch the T-molding all up. And the original T-molding was black, but this just looks, it's gonna set off a lot better, a lot more, because the marquee has purple in it. So, and it gives you a chance to be creative. Express yourself, don't just use the crappy black T-molding that always comes with it. Yeah, the channel on this, T-molding channel, groove, whatever you want to call it, it's actually kind of wide. Like, look, it's just flopping around. So I'm going to come up with something. Usually I just use hot glue to make it stick. Because, I mean, don't the T-molding just flop off while you're playing the damn game. Oh, come on, man. Well, that side sucked. Let's see if there's anything there. So, desperate times call for desperate measures. I'm actually going to drop my glue stick, hot glue the T-molding on. Alright, man. Put a marquee in and call it a night. Bitch. Marquee is in. What's next? Oh, we gotta do the bezel. Alright, well, I'm gonna call it quits tonight and we will pick up tomorrow. In shower, it's hot in this garage. We'll get the marquee, no, we'll get the bezel in. We'll get the control panel in. And then that'll probably be it for this video. Then we'll pick up with wiring in the game. All right, guys, see you in the morning. All right, so I ended up cracking the stupid plexiglass at the very end. So I'm gonna try to adhere using super glue the corner that I snapped off by accident. And this is gonna be potentially the lower part of the bezel, so you won't even see this. So the artwork's gonna go on top of this, and then we're gonna cover it with the good piece of plexiglass. So, I mean, if it doesn't work, we'll just use one piece, and then I'll worry about picking up another sheet some point in life, but I figure this is worth a shot. So I'm just gonna go over this edge. And then let this dry and then take up the tape and then I'll do the other edge. I mean underneath the tape. Story of my life. I hate working with plexiglass. Alright, so I'm gonna let that chill out and I'm gonna try to cut the other piece. Alright, I got my second sheet of plexiglass. This time I did not snap it. I made it a little bit longer because it actually, you can't see because it's black paint, but the plexiglass actually slides back in there a little bit. The first piece I cut, I actually cut just the distance between where the control panel is and the back wall. So it's kind of short, but and that was the piece that I snapped up anyway. So the idea is that piece is gonna be the bottom piece, and then this longer piece will kind of sandwich in between the control panel, I guess we'll call it a bracket, and the back wall. So I made it a little bit longer. And then the piece that I snapped, my super glue trick seems like it worked. I ran a piece of painter's tape on the other side too to kind of just hold it in place. It's not like it's gonna have any weight or anything stuck on it. But, and you're not gonna see this, it's gonna be covered up by the bezel, so I just need the centerpiece to be clean and crack free, and then this could be ugly and have paint, and it's not gonna be a big deal. And I decided to put it up in the right corner instead of the bottom, just in case, you know, somebody's playing it, they don't like lean on the friggin' bezel plexiglass, just to kind of, I don't know. Whatever. You know what I'm trying to say. So, I got my bezel cut out with an X-Acto knife. And I need to stick it on this thing. So, I'm going to set the tripod up and let's see if we can't get this bezel stuck to this glass, plexiglass. And I opted for the adhesive-backed bezel. It didn't really matter. I think it was like $4 extra. But I'm hoping it'll stay on a little bit better and not just slide around. So I'm gonna set this tripod up and let's get this bezel on. All right, we're gonna treat this just like we do the side art, where you tape it down in place so it doesn't wiggle, fold it back, peel off a little bit of the adhesive, cut off the adhesive, fold it back, get all the air bubbles out, and then work your way backwards. So let's see if this works. And you don't need to use the adhesive one because we're sandwiching it in between two sheets of plexiglass. It's not really necessary. However, I don't know why I bought these. That's a pain already. And it does not cut very well. Unless you have a razor blade. All right, man, get your squeegee out again. And I'm just gonna roll it on. Let me get rid of this. Let's see. Let's make it cleaner. Cool, and we got a little bit of air bubble, not even really air bubble up here, just from where I super glued that stupid piece. But anyway, it's not going anywhere, so you can remove your tape. Alright, fold back the yard again. Try just work with this side first. Let's see if this is doable. All And then this one just gonna kind of go in at like a corner angle. I'm getting some bubbles. I don't know what's going on. Yeah, it comes up pretty easy. You can just, if you mess it up, you can just pull it off and start over. Alright, so the... the artwork's on. And I mean, we could stop there and just throw it on. But I think another sheet will just, it'll just make it that much more, I don't know, give the illusion of glass, like that it's screen printed on, even though it's just a sticker. Oh, look, air bubble. Make sure you dust it off where you stick it on there. I kind of just, you know, I get impatient after a while. You don't want little garbage stuff stuck underneath of it. Okay. I'm gonna take this camera off and see if I can't get that out. All right, so we slid the bezel on and then put the other sheet of plexiglass on here. And what it didn't like is because there's actually no support up here, so the plexiglass was kind of like drooping. So my quick MacGyver thinking, I just took one of these Home Depot meter sticks and just kind of snapped it in half and then just ran it across here and wedged it in there just to kind of give it, I mean, it's nothing fancy or permanent or anything, but it just gives me a little bit of extra whatever. Hey, it's Jason from the future, and I figured out a way better technique than using that stupid meter stick. And we're just going to put in a couple angle brackets that I picked up from Walmart for like $2. And that's going to sandwich up, hold the plexiglass in place, and then this is going to mount to the back of the cabinet. So use these instead of a meter stick. Literally, that was like a month and a half ago, but I just stumbled across these and had an epiphany. Anyway, back to the past. Anyway, so since I put this bezel in, I don't know if you can tell from the camera or the lack of, actually, do I have a flashlight on me? I do have a flashlight and it's super bright. But one thing you might be able to tell is we have a giant gap from the bezel to the monitor. So apparently whenever they converted this to cool pool, they had this stupid like giant, well, we'll turn that back on, control panel that like went all the way up to here and ran all the way across and had like a trackball. So apparently to accommodate that giant stupid control panel, they had to move the monitor back about 3 inches, which sucks because now I gotta take the monitor back out, realign the brackets, and then hopefully my measurements are correct, stick the monitor back in, and it should look correct. I just hate taking these things out. They're so heavy, and if you make one mistake, you end up snapping like the glass tube or the neck or whatever you want to call it. So it's just a lot of stuff. We got to disconnect everything. Not looking forward to it. And you can see here, like, this is the bracket that we're messing with. We're going to slide that down. I think it's 3 inches. I'm going to take out a tape measure just to get the exact measurement. At least we have the angle. I'm thinking about it as I'm looking at it. You see that where the bezel's sitting, that piece of black wood at the top? That's a good indicator, at least for the angle that we need for the monitor to be mounted in. So we'll use that to get our slope. And then, Yeah, we're just going to slide down.
And it looks like when they put this in, they messed it up too. You see all these extra holes on the side. I don't think those are the original holes. Who knows? And then we got to get this old PCB board out too. Whoa. I'm just thinking to myself. Anyway, this is a good stopping point for now though. We have all the artwork done. We got the control panel overlay on, which is over here on my bench press. We got the bezel artwork on. We got the new marquee in, the new old marquee. We got the T-molding on, we have the kick plate on, and we have the sidearm on. So aesthetically, we're done. Whoa, I just hit my camera. Jesus. Aesthetically, let's try this again. We're done. Huh. Other than some rewiring of the controls and moving the monitor, this thing's almost done. But it's midnight now. After midnight, I don't feel like moving a monitor this late. So we'll pick up hopefully tomorrow and see if we can't get this thing up and running. All right, see you then. Okay, I've disassembled everything we just did because I got to move this monitor down. Well, it looks like 2.5 inches is what the measurement that I'm using. I pretty much just split the difference between the bezel and the middle of this black border of the monitor. And I think that should be fine, 2.5 inches. If not, we'll just redo it. So what I did, I already disconnected the monitor. I got the power from the monitor disconnected and the I don't know what you call this, the colors, your RGB signal. And I think that's it. Everything else is just part of the chassis. We don't need to disconnect any of that stuff. And we got 1, 2, 3, 4 bolts holding the monitor on. So we're gonna take that off so we can work a little bit easier without dropping things on our face. And then we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They're like, they're kind of like bolt screws, kind of. Like it's got a hex, like a wrench. And then, but I'm pretty sure the other side is a screw. Actually, it's weird, like I don't understand why, how only 5 screws are actually holding this heavy monitor up. Anyway, so we're gonna undo everything and then just shift everything down. You can actually see, here's some of the old holes. If these line up to be 2.5 inches, we might just use existing holes. I don't know if that's going to be bad, if it's like a loose like crevice. I don't want it to just fall out, because this is like a particle board cab, so I might just make new holes. Anyway, so let me pull this monitor out and then let's get a better view of what the hell we need to do. Man, I hate doing that every single time, because man does not make CRT monitors anymore. So if you bust it, you're pretty much SOL. Unless you want to go the LCD route, which I'm fine with most of the time. I mean, if I can help it, I try to keep it as original as possible with the CRTs and stuff. But this is gonna be way easier to work with without this stupid monitor in the way. Oh man, see how, like, remember I was saying that I'm surprised this thing even holds it in place? These things are loosey-goosey. I'm surprised the monitor didn't drop when I moved this thing. What's really getting to me is there's this line of holes underneath the mounting bracket that, like, almost makes me want to think that those are the original holes for that bracket. I don't know. You know what? I'm just going to stick to my plan. Just go down 2.5 inches.
Okie doke. Let's see if I cannot fail at putting this monitor back in. Got the brackets inched down about 2.5 inches. I kind of just eyeballed the angle using these. There's actually pieces of wood to go along for the bezel. But I don't think it's going to matter, even if it's slightly off. But I figure I'd turn the camera back on when I put this monitor in, just in case I fail and still make for a good video. All right, let's see if I can't do this. Damn heavy. Oh, shit. The monitor is back in. I just put the bezel up to see what I'm working with here, and it's a little bit lower than I want it to. Like, you can see it stops right at where the monitor is, and then we got, oh, let me get the glare off. See, there's a little bit of a gap up here, bigger than I wanted to. What I need to do is split difference from, man, this flashlight's killing it. Oh, hold on. Shit, I got a mess. I need to split the difference between here and here to kind of bring it up a little bit, but you know what? I don't really feel like messing with it. All right, so now that's in. We need to, what's left? We need to wire up the control panel. We need to, actually, that might be it, because you know what? I have a jamma. Jamma to Bosconian. I forgot the game we're using. Jamma to Bosconian adapter. So it's already wired for Jamma. Theoretically, I should be able to just plug the game right in once I get the thing wired up, and then we should be able to play some Bosconian. Okay, now we gotta reassemble the control panel that we took apart to put the CPU on. See if I can remember how to do this. Fire buttons in. This is just windshield cleaner. Windex, essentially. Just kind of get some of this crud out of the buttons before we put it back in. I'm not, you can take these things apart and like give it a thorough clean, but they're not that awful. And I don't feel like doing it. You know what? It makes more sense to put the joystick on first, since that's where all the wiring is coming from. This mess. Alright, so we got joystick, the disc thing, the rubber grommet, and the top part of the joystick. Which would then mount on that. But remember, we cut the grommet because it was just not coming off. I don't know. It's apparently, when I researched it, it's like a common issue that it just, the joystick will not come apart because of the stupid rubber grommet. So I ended up just cutting it with a razor blade. So now what I'm going to do is actually super glue it back, and hopefully it will stay. Even if it does stay, I mean, it's just keeping it in place. It's not going anywhere. Yeah, so this goes down first. That goes on top. This goes through here. Actually, the disc is actually underneath the control panel. So it actually goes disc, top plate, grommet, and then the joystick's gonna go all the way through. But Let's go ahead and mount these four control panel
bolt carriage things, whatever you want to call them.
Sliding on us.
Feet my disc up. It's stuck. Joysticks gonna go through.
And then we got the rubber grommet that's gonna go next. I assume it doesn't matter which side's what. I'm gonna try to match it up to where I ripped it off to begin with. I pretty much just put it together like a puzzle. And now I'm just gonna go around the bead where the crack was and just super glue it. I don't know if this is actually gonna do anything. Shall see. Probably won't do shit. Better than nothing, right? Whatever. I'm gonna let that dry. In the meantime, we gotta get. Now, the grommet itself bolts onto the top plate. And the reason I'm doing it now is just so that it doesn't move on us while I'm waiting for this super glue to dry. If it dries. All right, now that our grommet is super glued in place, everything's bolted in. Grommet to the top plate to the control panel, and now we gotta put this bottom plate, which is where your actual switches, and in this case, wiring harness. And which way, it doesn't really matter right now because I'm gonna rewire it anyway, but I labeled it beforehand with telling me which one's top and which one's bottom. So this is top. That means it goes on like so. It's really like, you get a 50-50 chance, if you have no idea. And then if, worst case, you just undo this top plate and switch around if your controls are backwards.
And then this one screws onto the top plate as well.
All right, what's next? I'm going to put this ball jammy on, and I can't remember how this goes. I think one goes inside the other. I don't know. I'm going to pause this and figure it out. Okay, I think I missed a step. But you know what? I'm not going back in time. So, I forgot to put this thing in between the two plates, which I'm not even really sure what the purpose of it is. But if you put this thingy, this little ball, half ball, I don't know. The thing that actually hits the contacts on the switch where it's supposed to go, it still works. It's not like, right here. See, I mean, it's still hitting the contacts. So I don't really know what that other piece does. I'm gonna hold on to it just in case it turns out that I do need to put it on. And then I'm gonna put this little clippy guy to make sure the retainer Make sure this thing doesn't come off. Yes, the joystick still works. I don't know. Maybe it's to prevent it from being pulled up. Don't know. Don't really care at this point. After messing with this thing for so many hours, you just kind of, I don't know, cut some corners. Okay, that's done. I'm tired of messing with that joystick. So, let's get these buttons in. Fire one, fire two. Associated button holder. Now it's time for the button nut. All right, now that all of our buttons are in, I went ahead and labeled each wire to their corresponding switch so that when I hook it up to the jamma harness, I can just look at the piece of tape and be like, okay, that goes left, this one's right, this one's start, etc. So let's get this in and see. I know I'm going to have to do some modifications to the jamma harness because there's some different Molex connectors, so I might just have to snip some stuff. Alright, my battery's gonna die, but real quick, this is essentially the process I'm going. The jamma harness in this case is actually labeled, so we're just gonna go through, we're gonna get player one start, player two start, switch one, up left, down right. I think that's all we need. So we're just gonna pull them from this harness. In this case, it was snipped for some stupid reason when they converted it, so I need to pull it out and then attach a longer wire to it. So I'm just gonna go down the line, there's gonna be a lot of unused buttons. Yeah, that's pretty much it. And I'm not gonna record this because it's pretty boring what I'm doing. But I'll show you again once I complete everything. Okay, so I went through each one. Actually, most of it was on another connector for the trackball for the crappy Cool Pool game. So I just snipped all those colors out, labeled them accordingly, and same thing with player one, player two start, and button switch one. So now all I gotta do is just match these labels up with the labels I made for the control panel. I think that's everything. I'm not gonna test this with the Bosconian board just yet. I'm gonna throw the Cool Pool back in just in case I cross some wires and it explodes. So let's try that out real quick. All right, let's test it with the Cool Pool. I'll figure out what the on button is. That's actually normal. It does this weird color pattern first. The stuff I want to test out is actually the controls. I don't know if I can control the pull cue with the joystick or not, or if I need the what's it called? Trackball. That seemed to do something. I don't know what I just did. don't know. The, wow, I didn't realize you were that close to my head. The, fire buttons, I guess, work. I don't know if they're, I don't know. Let's just go ahead and throw the Bosconian board in. Okay, Bosconian board is now plugged in. Let's see if I can get this closer. And here's nothing. Hold on to your butts. Hopefully that's normal. Hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Well, it's upside down for some reason. You can't see it, but at least we got an image. Upside down right away. You can tell the I don't know if you can tell. I'll bring it up. But watch the gun. See, they're like nowhere near the ship at all.
Alive.
And if I go left, at least it's on the same plane, but it's not. I don't know. But it's more or less working. So let me figure this crap out and then hopefully. Maybe we could play a game. Alright, we got the back door popped off. And I figured out by stroke of chance, luck, whatever you want to call it, why the ship was actually... You remember, well, of course you don't remember, it was like 2 seconds ago in the video. But it's actually been about a month, 2 months since I last picked up the camera. Trying to figure out what's wrong with this thing. So I'm gonna zoom in here. I got the lights, it's stupid dark. It's my cell phone. So I'm gonna zoom in, focus on the actual jamma adapter. You see that little black thing with a little gold? I'll see if I can point to it without being able to, that thing. So this little black piece here actually pops off and it was on this top prong right there. And I just messed with it and saw that it pulled off, so then I slid it down. And what that did was it put it into, it changes from cocktail mode to upright. So that's why the game image was upside down. If you had two player, the game image actually went right side up. And then in doing that, it also fixed the lasers going out of alignment with the spaceship. Oh my god, there's so much out of focus going on. And my flashlight app just died. So all I had to do was just pull that out and switch it around and it started working. But now that I got the back open, I'll show you how I got this thing mounted in here also. As soon as my flashlight app stops crashing on my phone, all I did to mount this is I put a zip tie, well it looks like three zip ties, looping it around, and then I stapled the excess to the side of the wall. That way it doesn't shake around, because originally I think this had like a metal, like slotted bracket, and it didn't. I didn't have that. I don't know what happened to it. They probably ditched it when they converted it back in the day. And then here's the jamma adapter I got from Mike's Arcade. Actually, his website's on there. And all it does is it just changes the pinout from the original Bosconian, Galaga. Oh, what else is in that? There's a whole bunch of games in that lineup of hardware that actually, it's the same pinout, so you can use this adapter for any of those games. And it just essentially just reroutes the pins to a jamma edge connector, like that one. And then there's a bunch of wires that I'd need to zip tie, go to the buttons that we just wired up. And that's pretty much it for that. And there goes my cell phone.
And then here's the bracket, angle bracket that I put on to get the bezel in place, or to keep it locked in place. And it was just a few bucks from Walmart. You can get them anywhere, Lowe's, hardware store, Home Depot, whatever. And I just screwed it to the back and left this side hanging out so that the bezel just slides into that, and now it can't go anywhere. So, I can't get on that side. If you push on the bezel, it's not going anywhere. Before we had like some droop action going on, and it didn't look good. So that's it. So now it works. I don't know why that switch flipped it, but if you have an issue with that jamma connector. So when I got it in the mail, that's what the switch that came on. It was defaulted to cocktail mode for whatever reason. So you might need to just pull that out and flip it. If anybody else knows what else that thing does, I'd be happy to hear, because I have no idea. Alright, so let's actually coin this thing up and play a game. All we have to do now is actually just play this thing. And there's a lot of MAME footage on YouTube, but maybe I've seen like one or two actual gameplay videos. So it's not like we're doing anything brand new, but we have to actually play the real game, which is a lot more than others can say. So without further ado, let's hit start and play some Bosconian. So it's pretty much, it's like Galaga meets, what is it, Sinistar, where you fly around? Which is a Williams game. And not 3D shooter, but open world shooter. When you hear that noise, it means you have this formation of five guys following you. If you shoot all of them, you get a bonus score of 500 points. You gotta watch out for these stupid meteors and the crazy stuff they shoot at you that looks like Tic Tacs. I don't know what's going on. And the object of the game is to actually just blow up these green space stations. Or reactors, or I don't know what they are. Green dealies. And you can do it by blowing up each round orb on either side. Or you just do a one-shot kill. Oh, God. And get that, and they flew in before I got the 500 points. You can do a one-shot kill with the base if you get it through the middle. See how there's two open spots on the middle? Oh, what's going on? I don't know what's happening. I don't know what's going on. Oh, I died. I was too busy trying to shoot the base to understand what that warning meant. So you get various warnings. Alert, alert, which kind of sounds, or is it an alarm? I don't know. The voice synthesizer is not that great. But anyway, I'm going to do a one-shot kill on this base. Jesus. I'm going to try to. Plus 500. If you shoot right up the middle and get inside. Bam, there we go. Kind of like Star Wars, where you're shooting it through the vent. And then you have these mines that get in your way. Anything you see on the screen. Any sprite you can blow up. But if you want to get more points, you want to blow up each individual orb. If you just want to beat the level as fast as you can, just shoot right down the middle. And it gets more harder. It's really hard to speak while you're playing a video game. It gets harder each level. Like that time, they added another guy to the that formation that comes after you. So you watch. Where's he at? There they are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you get 1,000 points if you kill them that time. Jesus.
Locked off. Alive, alive.
Mm-hmm. Formation attack. And they killed me. Bastards.
Locked off.
Anyway. And you can't really see it from the contrast of the camera and the screen. But there's a map on your right side that tells you where all those bases are. So if you just want to not fly around like an a-hole, you can just go right towards the base. So there's one. Let's go far left. Formation attack. Got that guy. And there should be one up here.
Alive! Alive!
A lot of bases in this level. And
blocked off.
Thought that was game over.
Alive, alive.
That was simple enough.
Alive,
there's
alive.
Another row of them on the left side.
Alive, alive.
Shit.
Blocked
two
off.
Left.
Alive,
you hear Aerosmith blast in the background from Revolution X. It's a recent pickup I got. There we go.
Blocked
oh man, there's
off.
A lot of bases. I wish you could see on my map.
Alive, alive.
Let's see, one, two. And then if you get to one side of the map, it just kind of puts you on the other side of the map. Kind of like, I think that's the first time I got a high score in this game. Go for the record. Can I put my initials in? No? Okay. So, that's Bosconian. Let me turn the lights on. It's a super fun game. People hate on it because it's not Galaga, which is why most of these were converted back in the day. So that's it, guys. Bosconian, rare breed. All right, guys, well, thanks for checking out these couple videos. If you have any questions about where I got artwork or how I did something, if I didn't go over anything in as much detail as you'd like, please feel free to leave a comment or shoot me a message. And I will respond to you shortly. And if you haven't checked out the other videos, it'd be awesome if you did. You know it'd be even more awesome if you subscribed and then shared some videos out. Because we're going to be doing a lot more of this stuff. Because, let's see, I got a whole bunch of projects over here just kind of waiting to be messed with. So, alright guys, well thanks for checking this out and I'll see you next time. Later!